NASA knows a lot about physics. Their engineers know what are the good characteristics of a communication antenna. But sometimes, even they have a hard time designing the best antenna with all the desired characteristics. With these problems, they now try to look into some other directions, some other algorithms, some other new techniques. And they find part of their answer in nature, in human beings, in living systems, the way they evolve, and that they will interact with nature and improve themselves. And they apply the same concepts to algorithms. The twisted thing that you see on your top left, beside that coin, is actually a communications antenna of a satellite. And it's highly unlikely that a human expert might have actually arrived at it. Welcome to the world of evolutionary algorithms, where an algorithm is actually an organism. And I am Deepak Dawar, doing my thesis in computer science on evolutionary algorithms. Now, it is a very revolutionary idea for computer researchers like me. Now, to solve hard problems, when we don't have any new technique, we look at nature. For example, we look at ants. These ants, they have such small, tiny creatures, they still have such sophisticated transportation mechanisms. We are still not able to ape. Me personally, I look at human gene mutations, and I come with variations of new evolutionary algorithms, combine them with mathematical theory, and to solve very hard problems. One of my algorithms was successfully applied in classification of vehicles flying on a highway. Now, when you know the type, the kind, and the number of vehicles that are going on a highway, you can design the routes much better in terms of width, thickness, and the quality of material that you want to use. That has a long-lasting economic impact. But most importantly, one of my algorithms was applied to 20 seemingly very hard problems in computer science, and it achieved an efficiency of 20% in running time. What implications does that have? Just look at this war-torn area in Africa. If you want to spread, if you want to distribute money or food or water to these needy people, there's so many factors you have to take into consideration. For example, we should know how many mammals, how many people we have to serve, how many resources we have, all this taken into consideration. But in the end, an algorithm will do the job for you. It will compute the best routes for you to get there. Now, so it might seem like an easy problem. You know, just suppose we have 15 cities, how hard would it be to just distribute the food? But the data seems and it says otherwise. For just 15 cities, the amount of time required to get the best route is actually 50 days. If we apply my algorithm and we improve upon it for 20% of running time, that means we save 10 days. Those 10 days can be used for distributing instead of just computing how to get there. This might seem like an easy thing, but if somebody gets help with the definition of my algorithms, I'll be the most happiest person. Thank you.